So I come to tell you he's alive, to tell you that he dries every tear that falls.
Hey everybody, Clint Louie here, coming to us with 5 minutes from Friendship. Let me ask you a question. Are you supposed to just believe anything you hear? Are you supposed to believe just anything somebody tells you? I mean, granted, of course, there may be people you have confidence in, and if they tell you something, then you feel like that they're telling you the truth. But I'm just talking about in general. Do you just believe anything that somebody says? How about if somebody says that what they're doing is of God? Should you just accept that on face value? Well, the answer is no. No, and let me give you a scripture verse on that. 1 John chapter 4, verse 1. 1 John 4, verse 1. The Bible says, "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world." The Bible says, "Believe not every spirit." So number one, I need to make a conscious choice. I'm not going to just believe what anybody and everybody says because they claim to be saying it in the name of Jesus. Number two, I'm to try the spirits, meaning I should take it to the scripture. Many of you may remember the name Jonathan Edwards, and you've probably heard the famous sermon, "Sinners in the Hands of an Angry God." And Jonathan Edwards was a tool God used mightily, a man God used mightily during the Great Awakening of our country in the 1700s. In 1741, Jonathan Edwards delivered the commencement address at Yale, and the address was later published. And in that address at Yale, he spoke up about revival, and then he spoke about how can you determine where what is genuinely of the Holy Spirit. He gave the students, the graduates, some thoughts on how can you test and discover what is genuinely of the Holy Spirit of God. And he gave five things, five tests, and I'm going to give them to you. Number one, he said the Holy Spirit, the work he does, will number one, exalt Jesus Christ. He exalts Jesus Christ. In other words, the Holy Spirit is not here to lift up even himself, but he's here to lift up Jesus Christ. He is to give you and me a proper understanding and a thirsting and a longing for the Son of God, who Jesus is, that he is God in human flesh, that he came, lived a sinless, perfect life, was crucified, buried, and risen again the third day, and that he's glorified. The Lord is glorified, and the Holy Spirit will exalt the true Christ. So the Holy Spirit, number one, he'll exalt the true Christ. Number two, what the Holy Spirit does is he opposes Satan's interests. He opposes the devil's work. The Holy Spirit works against sin. He restrains sin and Satan's interests. And so where the Holy Spirit is moving, where revival is breaking out, where the Holy Spirit is working, Satan's kingdom will be opposed. Jesus will be exalted. And then Jonathan Edwards said, thirdly, that the Holy Spirit will point people to the scriptures, that he will point people to the truth of God in the Word of God. You know what? One of the most dangerous things is that people get so caught up in experiences and spiritual experiences. And then they say, "I know what I saw," or "I know what I felt." And they say that even ignoring the Word of God. But the Holy Spirit doesn't ignore the Word of God. The Holy Spirit exalts Christ, opposes Satan, and points us to the Scripture, the written Word of God. Number four, the Holy Spirit will elevate truth. Jonathan Edwards said the Holy Spirit will elevate truth. How do I know where the Spirit of God is working? He will elevate truth. People will be hungry for sound doctrine. People will be thirsty for what does the Lord say in his word. I need something greater than some guy's prophetic vision or dream. How do I know he just didn't eat a bad pizza last night and it kept him up and he thought he had a dream? I mean, really and truly, I need something more sure. And the Holy Spirit gives us that. He gives us the truth of God's word. And then finally, Jonathan Edwards said the fifth thing that the Holy Spirit will do is his work results in love for God and for others. He will stir up love for God and for others. You want to know where the Holy Spirit's working? He's working where people love God and they love one another. So these are five tests that Jonathan Edwards gave to us, and I think they're right on point. I wanted to share them with you today. Thank you for joining me. God bless you. Have a great day.